President Museveni wants the 10th Parliament to pass policies and bills that will ensure that Uganda reduces on the importation of goods that can be manufactured locally, alongside putting measures to curb illegal fishing.
Out of the 21 fish processing factories, 12 have closed. The others are limping on, operating at less than 30% capacity and only earning $96 million per annum. This shame will not be allowed to continue.
The president also told the nation that his main focus this term is to fight what he described as the economic bleeding syndrome that Uganda is faced with due to the trade imbalance and blackmail by foreign business entities, among them commercial banks.
Ugandan companies should also be more careful in dealing with these banks, because some of them use their ignorance. The government is now fully aware. I've got a big report by the Prime Minister. There are so many companies which are having a lot of problems, these companies, of our people.
As a strategy to support the economy, the president has ordered government institutions to buy locally manufactured goods, partly to save the country the over $5.5 billion it spends on imports. Long-time politician Tom Butime, however, is concerned that reducing on import trade was the strategy 30 years ago, and hopes that this time round, President Museveni will live to his word.
That is how we started. The debate was, Uganda must take control of its economy, isn't it? We must produce and sell. We must import important, essential things for the people, isn't it? The rest of the trinkets, at that time we call them trinkets, isn't it? Those should not be, we should not spend money on them. 30 years down the road, isn't it? We are almost on the same question.
Other politicians we spoke to were contented with the State of the Nation address.
You know, in terms of job creation, we already have our youth, young ones, who are not employed. And the moment we produce here locally, we shall be creating jobs for them.
So basically, I see this as a welcome idea, that we shall be able to not only improve the production of the primary material in agriculture, but we shall improve the value of agricultural products.
The State of the Nation address ushers in the 10th Parliament to start conducting business, with 29 bills lined up by government to see to it that President Museveni's directives are implemented. Rebecca Emmanuel, reporting for Urban Television.